the joys we knew, that yearning, returning, to hold you in my arms. Won't go, love, I know, love, without you night has lost its charms. When day is done and grass is wet with twilight's dew, my lonely heart is sinking with a song. Although I miss your tender kiss the whole day through, I miss you most of all when day is done.
What's behind the bright lights of the sky signs? Here's the biggest one of them all. Let's take it apart and see what makes it click. A regular forest of globes. Enough steel for a skyscraper. And that's what it is, 23 stories high. By day, this sparkling giant of the night needs a lot of care. What are those things up there? Flies? No, sir. They're the men behind the bright lights. Sign monkeys who scramble about this sky alphabet as easy as A, B, C. They're a hard-working crew who shinny up and down a lot of ropes to be sure that every one of these millions of lights will keep on duty through the night. You have to know your ropes to get anywhere in this contraption. A bosun chair, it's called. And it's just like those the sailors use when they repair the rigging on a boat. If your feet don't get mixed up in starting, you're okay. Ah! There is a knack to this. Like picking flowers in a glass garden. And the bigger the garden, the more men it takes to keep them all in bloom. Just a good day's work for new globetrotters. Such a business. But all those little lights must twinkle brightly in the night sky. This moving sign is called a motograph. There are more than 8,000 lights in this one. And with a life of only 6 to 8 months to a globe, rarely a day passes without 30 or 40 having to be replaced. No, his knees aren't shaking, that's the wind. Hardly any superstition among these fellows. Cat's feet are a lot more help than rabbit's feet. Of course, in a 40 or 50 mile an hour gale, there's no three on a match. Well, after all, a fella can fall only once, they say. Once he gets going, there's nothing he can do about it, so why worry? But the sign monkeys are only a part of the crew it takes to keep the bright lights bright. An electrical engineer is always on the job, and what a break they give him. He rates an elevator. Going up, call your floor. 15th, please, electrical goods and glassware. Look in this control room. 100 things to watch all at one time. This is the flasher. It controls the lights that move around the big circle. The flasher is simply a rotating drum. On the face of this drum are what are known as contact plates. Metal strips or brushes along the side are lined up opposite the contacts on the drum. Each contact and its brush controls a group of lights on the sign. Naturally, the more contacts and brushes there are turning groups of lights on and off, the more combinations we'll have. The flasher control has 305 separate contacts, the largest one in the world. Here is the machine that controls the clock hands, and it has kept the clock in perfect time for over a year without a slip. This is the control for the moving motograph. You want to know how it works? Well, every light bulb connects by a wire to a small contact point or brush. The tip of the brush presses against a copper plate, and the return wire carries electricity through the plate, brush, and wire to light the lamp. A strip of paper inserted between the copper plate and the brush stops the flow of electricity and the lights go out. But wherever a hole in the paper lets the brush touch the copper plate, electricity flows through again and lights the bulb. No matter how many light bulbs and brushes are connected, each of them operates the same. This is a motograph sign panel studded with thousands of light bulbs. And this is the contact board on the motograph control carrying thousands of brushes. Each light bulb on the sign panel connects to a brush on the contact board. A copper plate is hinged to the contact board and a wire goes to the plate. As the copper plate is pressed against the brushes, electricity passes from the plate through the brushes and wires to the lights, and they all go on. If a strip of paper is passed between the copper plate and the brushes, the lights will all go out. But wherever holes in the paper permit any brushes to touch the copper plate, the lights connected to these brushes will go on. The message is punched in a roll of heavy paper, like a player piano roll. When the paper travels between the brushes and the copper plate, different groups of lights on the sign panel flash on and off. And when running, makes you think the lights are moving when they're not. Now, let's have another look at the motograph control. These wires leading from the lights all connect with the brushes at the back of the contact board. The paper carrying the motograph message is put between the brushes and the copper plate door. Then the plate goes against the paper and the brushes are clamped into place. The rest of the paper record is put on rollers so it will run through the motograph smoothly. The switch is turned on, the motograph goes into action, and the animated message is flashed across the display. And so, clambering over the face of this giant of the night, the man behind the bright lights has only to be a combination engineer, electrician, strongman, juggler, and the man on the flying trapeze. Anyhow, there's very little traffic up here. Just think of the poor pedestrians down there, dodging back and forth among those cars. What chances people do take. A fellow is certainly a lot safer up here.